गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, हाउ आर यू ऑल? होप यू ऑल आर फाइन. वंस अगेन गेट रेडी फॉर आवर इंग्लिश क्लासेस. यस्टरडे वी हैड कंप्लीटेड द एक्सरसाइज ऑन सेंटेंसेस, राइट? हैव यू ऑल कंप्लीटेड योर वर्क? होप ऑल ऑफ यू हैव कंप्लीटेड योर वर्क. एंड हूएवर हैज नॉट कंप्लीटेड, एटलीस्ट कंप्लीट योर वर्क टुडे. एंड नाउ we are going to start with a new chapter of the reader There Isn't Time, right? You all have hobbies? Everybody has hobbies? Yes. What are your hobbies? Can anybody tell me? Yes, some like listening music, some like reading books, some like collecting stamps, some like collecting coins. What is your hobby? Think about it. How much time are you giving for your hobby? The whole day? Acha, tell me, what is hobby? Hobby is something that you do to get happiness, to get pleasure, to relax your mind, right? So the hobby, like listening music, why do you listen music? It gives you pleasure, excitement. Acha lagta hai, it relaxes your mind. So listening music is a hobby. There are various hobbies which are pursued by various children. Everybody has its own hobby. Some like playing games. Yes, playing games is also a hobby. How much time are you giving? Do you give the whole day for your hobby? Do you have that much time to give for your hobby? No, you don't have that much time. Then how much time do you allot for your hobby? How much time do you give for your hobby? 1 hour? Are you giving daily? Maybe sometimes you don't have time to give, right? So we are going to read about a poem which is written by Eliana Fergion. Eliana Fergion was a famous English writer. She wrote poems for children, and in this poem, her favorite hobby was traveling. She wanted to travel the whole world, but she had a problem. She did not have that much time. So she wrote a poem for you all, that There Isn't Time. The name of the poem is There Isn't Time. And for writing poems for children, she has won many awards. And today, young children are given awards in honor for writing. So this is a poem about There Isn't Time. In this poem, the writer has no time to do the things she wants to do, right? In her poem, the poet talks about the lack of time. She wants to explore the world, meet people, but she does not have enough time to do all the things. However, she does not have time to do any of this. This poem is a comment to the nature that today our lives have become so busy that we do not have enough time to do the things we like, right? So shall we start the poem? Okay, ready? So everybody will open out the page number 11 of your reader book, right? See, this is your page 11 of your reader book. So the name of the poem is There Isn't Time. And this poem is written by Eliana Fergion. Who is the writer of the poem? Eliana Fergion. Let's read the poem. There isn't time, there isn't time, there is no time to do the things I want to do. Whatever things I want to do, like I want to do drawing, I want to do singing, I want to travel, but I don't have any time. But for what things she does not have the time? With all the mountain tops to climb. You know what is a mountain? Hindi mein hum pahar bolte hai na? अच्छा, हमारे इंडिया में कितने पहाड़ हैं आप लोग को पता है? डू यू नो? कैन यू नेम सम माउंटेन्स ऑफ इंडिया? एनीबडी थिंक अबाउट द माउंटेन्स ऑफ इंडिया? यस, हिमालयाज, राइट. any more? Yes, think, think. The Satpuras, right. The Kanchenjunga, the Annamudi mountain range. There are many mountains in India, and during your vacation, during your holidays, you go to hill stations. Why do you go to hill stations? Because due to lot of trees on the mountains, the atmosphere is very pure and you like over there. It is not very hot like Khargone. It is very cool over there. So that is why in holidays and all, you like to go to the mountains to see the greenery, to observe the nature. So in the same way, the poet also wanted to climb all the mountain tops and all the woods to wander through. Now what do you mean by woods? Anybody? Acha, think. We'll take out the word meaning of woods. Okay, woods. From where do you get woods? You get woods from trees. And where do you get trees? Trees are in the forest. So what do you mean by woods? You mean forest. Yes. She wanted all the forest to wander through. She wanted to go through the forest and see all the trees over there, type of trees, type of birds which are flying over there, type of animals which live in the forest. Right. So, in this poem, did you observe one thing? See, there isn't time, there isn't time to do the things I want to do, and all the woods to, with all the mountain tops to climb. Now see, time, climb. Are you getting the same sound? Yes. So these time and climb are known as rhyming words. And why do the poems have rhyming words? The poem has rhyming words to give it a musical effect. Right? Further moving, so the first paragraph is all about that the poet is complaining that he has no time in the world to do the things he wants to do. Now what are the things he wants to do? He wants to climb the mountain tops. He wants to wander through the forest. Wander, wander means to walk around aimlessly. Aimlessly, bina kisi matlab ke jungle mein chale ja rahe hain, chale ja rahe hain. कोई सोचा नहीं है कहाँ जाना, क्या करना, क्या नहीं करना, पर हम चले जा रहे हैं. जंगल देखना हमको बहुत अच्छा लगता है. वुड्स मीन्स फॉरेस्ट एंड फॉरेस्ट मीन्स जंगल, राइट. एंड ऑल द सीज टू सेल अपॉन. नाउ ही वॉन्ट्स ऑल द सीज. कैन यू नेम सम सीज ऑफ इंडिया? यस, अरेबियन सी, करेक्ट. सो ही वॉन्ट्स टू एक्सप्लोर द सीज एंड एवरी वेयर देर इज टू गो, ऑल द प्लेसेस. Every each and every corner of the world the poet wants to travel, and all the people, everyone, he wants to meet everyone, he wants to talk to everyone. And then who lives upon the earth, who all are living on this earth, he wants to know everyone. Now see, the people living in Maharashtra, Maharashtrians, the people living in Bengal are Bengalis, the people living in Tamil Nadu, Tamils. So these are the type of peoples which she wanted to explore. She wanted to meet every people. She wanted to know their culture. She wanted to know their language they speak. She wanted to know how they do their work, what is their lifestyle, what is the dressing sense. She wanted to know every each and everything of the people who live on the earth. To know a few and do a few. कुछ को पहचानती और कुछ करना चाहती थी. एंड देन सिट डाउन एंड आफ्टर एक्सप्लोरिंग द होल वर्ल्ड, आफ्टर क्लाइंबिंग ऑल द माउंटेन टॉप्स, आफ्टर सेलिंग द सीज, आफ्टर वॉन्डरिंग इन द वुड्स, शी वॉन्टेड टू सिट डाउन एंड मेक अ राइम. नाउ हियर राइम मीन्स शी वॉन्टेड टू राइट डाउन अ पोएम. शी वॉन्टेड टू राइट डाउन अ पोएम, राइट. सो अबाउट द रेस्ट आई वॉन्ट टू डू. सी, शी हैज डन सो मच. And what else she wants to do? She wants to make a list of it, and then she wants to do that work also. So this is the poem all about that A poet in this poem has no time to do the things she likes. She loves to traveling and she wants to explore the whole world, but she has no time to explore it, because in this age where we are living, life has become very busy. 8 hours you are spending in the school, then you go home, you have your food and all, then you have to sit down to do your homework, then you go out to play. Where is the time for you also to pursue your hobby, the things you like? You don't have enough time to do the things you like. In the same way, the poet also does not have enough time to do the things she likes, and that's why she has written down the poem, "There Is a Time." Hope the poem is very, very clear to you all. Yes? Clear? Okay. So let's repeat the poem. All of you will repeat after me. "There Isn't Time" is written by Elena Ferjum. Yes, you all will repeat after me. Start repeating after me. "There isn't time, there isn't time to do the things I want you to do. There isn't time, there isn't time to do the things I want you to do. With all the mountain tops to climb, with all the mountain tops to climb, and all the woods to wander through, and all the woods to wander through, and all the seas to sail upon, and all the seas to sail upon, and everywhere there is to go, and everywhere there is to go, and all the people everyone, and all the people everyone who lives upon the earth to know, who lives upon the earth to know a few, to know a few and do a few, and then sit down and make a rhyme, and then sit down and make a rhyme about the rest I want you to do. About the rest I want you to do." So you all were repeating after me? Sure? I think someone has not repeated after me. Who has not repeated? Repeat it once again. "There isn't time, there isn't time to do the things I want to do. With all the mountain tops to climb and all the woods to wander through, and all the seas to sail upon, and everywhere there is to go, and all the people everyone who lives upon the earth to know a few and do a few, and then sit down and make a rhyme about the rest I want to do." Yes. So here we end up with the poem. The poem is "There Isn't Time" and is written by Elena Ferjum, right? Now, turn the page. We come to page number 12. Here in this bracket, in this box, we get the information about Elena Ferjum. Now, let's see. Here some dates are written. 1881-1965. So, 1881 means she was born in 1881 and she died in 1965, right? When was Elena Ferjum born? Elena Ferjum was born in 1881 and she died in 1965. Who was Elena Ferjum? She was an English writer, right? Now, she is chiefly remembered for her children's stories and poems. So she would write stories for children and poems for children. And basically all the children remember her for her writings and stories. During her lifetime, she won many awards. In her life, she has won many awards. Today, the Elena Ferjum Award is presented to the talented children's author in her honor. Now she is no more. But in her honor, the award is being given to the children who all are writing poems and stories, best writers, right? Irina Fajian's most popular work is the hymn Morning Has Broken, as well as the book Martin Pippin's In the Apple Orchard and its sequel Martin Pippin in the Daisy Field, right? So these are her famous write-ups. If you want to read them, yes, you can search it on the Google, you'll get the books, or else we can have it in the library also. Ask your library, sir, ask your parents, that's, Papa, I want to read this book, from where will I get it? When you start exploring things, you will start getting more ideas, right? So let's recall what is the story about. The story is about the poet who has no time to do the things she wants to do. Now, what are the things she wants to do? She wants to climb the mountain tops. She wants to wander through the forest. Then she wants to sail the seas. She wants the people, to meet the people on the earth. She wants to do some work. She wants to sit down and write a rhyme. So these are the things which she wants to do, right? So are you all clear about the poem? Okay. Now tell me what the poet wants to do. The poet has all the time to do what she wants to do, very little time to do what she wants to do, no time at all to do what she wants to do. Which one is the correct answer? Can anybody give me the correct answer? Yes. Yes, Karnika, Vamakshi, Sharvil. Yes. Yes, the poet has no time to do all the things what she wants to do. The poet wishes she could visit every beach, climb all the mountain tops, stay in different cities. What does the poet want to do? He wants to stay in different cities, is it right? Or he wants to visit all the beaches? He wants to climb all the mountain tops. In this poem, what we came to know is the poet wants to climb all the mountain tops. Next, the poet wants to travel the world. Why does the poet wants to travel the world? The poet wants to travel the world to see new places. Does he want to see new places, meet new people, see new places and get to know new people? What is right? Yes. In the poem we came across the word, and everywhere there is to go, and all the people, everyone who lives upon the earth to know. So he wants to go everywhere and meet everyone. So the right answer is see new places and get to know new people, right? After doing everything, the poet would then want to, what will the poet do after doing all the things? After climbing the mountain tops, after wandering in the forest, after sailing the seas, after meeting every people, after going to every place, what is the last work he wants to do? Yes, and then sit down and make a rhyme about the rest I want to do. So what is going to do? Write a play about her experience. Play matlab natak. Compose a short story about her experience. She is going to write a short story. Write a poem about the remaining things she wants to do. And then sit down and make a rhyme about the rest. Rest matlab remaining things. Rest I want to do. Yes. So the right answer is he is not going to write a play. Na wo koi natak likhega, na wo koi story likhega. वो लिखेगी तो वो लिखेगी जो उसको और करना है. अभी तो काफ़ी सारी चीज़ें बाकी है. अभी तो उसने सिर्फ लिस्ट में इतना लिखा है कि उसे क्या क्या करना है, अभी तो बाकी लिस्ट बाकी है, इनकम्प्लीट है उसकी लिस्ट। तो हमारा राइट आंसर रहेगा, राइट अ पोएम अबाउट द रेस्ट, अबाउट द रिमेनिंग थिंग्स शी वॉन्ट्स टू डू, राइट। सो लेट्स रिवाइज वंस अगेन, द पोएट हैज नो टाइम एट ऑल टू डू वॉट शी वॉन्ट्स टू डू। यस, द पोएट हैज नो टाइम टू डू वॉट शी वॉन्ट्स टू डू, राइट। आफ्टर दिस this one, the poet has no time at all to do what she wants to do, okay। next, the poet wishes she could visit every beach, she wanted to visit every beach, no। climb all the mountain tops, yes। so the poet wishes she could climb all the mountain tops। the poet wants to travel the world too, why does the poet wants to travel the world, yes, to see new places and get to know new people, and he wants to visit the new places, know new people and meet everyone। after doing everything, after finishing all the work, what is the thing poet wants to do, yes, the poet wants to write a story, no। the poet wants to write a play, no। then what is the poet going to do, the poet is going to write a poem about the remaining things she wants to do, right। so here we come to the end of the poem, and the poem is about the poet has no time to do the things he wants to do, secondly the poem is written by Elena Fergion। so after this you are going to open your classwork copies, all of you will open your classwork copies, write down the heading, write down the heading, chapter 2, there is a time by Elena Fergion, right। so this poem is written by Elena Fergion, okay। after this we are going to write down the along with the margin dictation words, right, you are going to write down dictation words, yes, spelling of mountain, number 1, mount mountain, mountain, what do you mean by mountain, pahad, correct, so mount, count count, count mount mount, mount mount, mountain, A-I-N-N, mountain, right। the next spelling, wander, next word is wander, w-a-n-d-e-r, what do you mean by wander, yes, to walk around aimlessly, बिना किसी मतलब के घूमते रहना, राइट, वॉन्डर, वॉन डब्ल्यू ए एन वॉन डी आर ड वॉन्डर, राइट। नेक्स्ट वर्ड, व्हाट इज द नेक्स्ट वर्ड, थ्रू, टी एच आर ओ यू जी एच, थ्रू, द वेरी फर्स्ट साउंड विच यू आर गेटिंग इज थ, th th through, r o u g h, through, right। The next word is everywhere. Every, E-V-E-R-Y, everywhere, W-H-E-R-E, everywhere, har jagah, right? Every, what is the spelling of every? E-V-E-R-Y, every, where, W-H-E-R-E, right? Everywhere. Next, people. We always make a spelling mistake with writing people, right? So let's learn the spelling correctly. People. P-E-O-P-L-E. We write P-O-E. We always get confused. People. Or we write P-E-E-P-A-L. But no, here it is people. P-E-A. P-E-O, sorry. P-L-E. People. Right? The next word is rhyme. Last word, number 6, rhyme. R-H-Y-M-E, rhyme. R-H-Y-M-E. Now children, you are going to write this dictation words in your classwork copies very neatly and correctly without making any spelling mistakes. Are you all writing down, noting down the words? Okay, I'm waiting for 5 minutes for you so that you may complete your work, right? Yes, what is the first word? Mountain. Mount. Count. Same sound, but the only difference is M. The word is starting with M, so we are going to write it M. Mount. M-O-U-N-T. Mount. Count, K, C, C-O-U-N-T, right? So what is the spelling of mountain? Are you repeating after me? M-O-U-N-T-A-I-N. Keep repeating the spellings while writing. When you repeat the spelling while writing, you will learn the spelling also. Next word is wander. W-A-N, wander, dirt, D-E-R, dirt. Right? Through. Th. It is starting with th. T-H. Through. T-H-R-O-U-G-H. Through. How will you pronounce it? Through. Everywhere. E-V-E-R-Y. Everywhere. W-H-E-R-E. Everywhere. People. P-E-O-P-L-E. Simple. People, come on, repeat after me. P-E-O-P-L-E, people. Rhyme, R-H-Y-M-E, rhyme, R-H-Y-M-E, rhyme, okay? After this dictation words, you will write down the poem, okay? After completing your dictation words, you are going to write down the poem. Now see, how you are going to write down the poem? There is a time our copy also, we will complete only this much line. Even if space is left, you are not going to write, because a poem is not written like a paragraph or a story. A poem is written the way we have to write the poem, the way it ends, okay? Time to do the things. Now the next line, after here even the space is left. I am not writing here. You will come on to the next line. To do the things, to do the things I want to do, right? So in this way you are going to write down the poem. After, even if your space is again left, but I am not going to write it. I will come on to the next line. With all the mountain with all the mountain tops to climb. Right? Are you getting? So you are going to write down the poem in this way. And all the birds to wander through. Right? So you are going to complete your poem in this way. Okay? Clear? Let's repeat the poem once again. Everybody get together and let's repeat the poem. Yes. There isn't time to do the things I want to do, with all the mountain tops to climb and all the woods to wander through, and all the seas to sail upon, and everywhere there is to go, and all the people, everyone who lives upon the earth to know a few and do a few, and then sit down and make a rhyme about the rest I want to do. So you're going to learn the poem, okay? Everybody will repeat the poem, learn it thoroughly, and then you can, when you come to school, then you can recite the poem, okay? And this poem is written by Ileana Fergio. So what is your homework? Homework is learning the dictation words and completing your poem. And here we come to the end of this session, right? Okay, bye. Hope you all will recite the poem, read the poem the way I have pronounced it, learn the pronunciation with action. Okay, bye.